Before the Committee of Natural Resources today to justify the budget estimates for the sector, officials of the Ministry of Energy and Mineral Development, led by the Minister of State for Energy, Sidronius Okasai, pleaded with the committee to support the ministry to get more 30 billion shillings for Karuma Hydropower Project to get operationalized.
To our Committee of Environment and Natural Resources, we have listened to each other. This operational issue is arising from the supplementary which you provided. We asked you to provide funds for operationalized insurance in the last supplementary, but that money has not been released to us. This is what you are pushing me to say, actually.
Okasai told the committee that although the project construction has been completed, it can't get operationalized before it's fully insured.
Insurance. Should anything happen, you are not protected in any way.
The plant has no issues.
No.
The construction would be completed. When you start operating it, that insurance is not there.
Of the 30 billion shillings, only 10 billion shillings has been allocated, leaving a funding gap of 20 billion shillings, of which is for insurance, operational and management costs, and owner's engineer. However, committee members wondered how the ministry failed to provide insurance fees on the project budget to avoid such a delay.
Here in their submissions, they are asking for more money. Actually, even the 10 billion is not supposed to be provided because the operations and the maintenance is supposed to come from the tariffs.
But the problem was procurement. Of all those, the contractor, the first owner's engineer, all those ones. So we should be looking at that one, but not insurance. Didn't you know that you'd be having that dam?
Isn't Karuma operationalizing to capacity because of operational issues? Or they are not operating because they are fearing to risk operating without the insurance, which is, I just want to understand.
Karuma is a 600 megawatt hydroelectric power project whose construction began in December 2013. The $1.7 billion project is largely funded by Export and Import Bank of China, Exim, and implemented by China's Sino Hydropower Company. Its completion targets have had several extensions. Meanwhile, MPs and the Parliamentary Committee of Natural Resources have pleaded with officials of the Minister of Energy and Mineral Development to have some changes made so as to cement their political capital as 2026 draws nearer.
Before we continue, let the PS and the Minister is here confirm to us. Honorable Chair, we wrote reports and forwarded them to you. But every time we come here, you are being worked upon. We have reached a campaign. I'm a politician who needs a sound ground during the campaign. What is boosting my performance really on this committee, Honorable Chair?
Can you point us in this ministerial post statement where you've taken care of their interests? Those are the modifications to Honorable Katenya that I wanted to make.
So we can actually take your interests further in that one to allocate you some lines. And we have tried to cover countrywide where we have some allocation by district. But for the committee members, when you come, we shall look at what provisions there are, and we can spell to you what we promised you in the when we're processing the loan.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.